Now on Night B, a swarm of police, flashing lights, and confusion descending on a house in a quiet Palo Alto neighborhood. Inside, they found a Facebook executive. Good evening. I'm Veronica Dela Cruz.
I'm Ken Bastida. This all started when police got a disturbing 911 call, but as Night B's Maria Medina found out, it was all a hoax.
The prank is called swatting, calling 911 to report a crime that would bring on heavy police presence. It happened here in this Palo Alto neighborhood last night off Emerson Street from a caller with an untraceable number.
Come out with their hands up one at a time.
Monisha White heard the police commands loud and clear.
And I heard them tell somebody to go back inside the house.
As officers surrounded a home just a few doors down after 9 p.m.
Turn around. With your hands up.
Police detained a Facebook cybersecurity executive whose name was the same as the 911 caller. The caller told the dispatcher he'd shot his wife, was holding his kids hostage, had pipe bombs, and would hurt police once they arrived.
I thought it's possible there's a false alarm.
And you were right.
Yeah, turns out it was a hoax.
Turns out the man and another person living in the home had no idea what was going on, and police quickly learned they'd all been had.
Walk this way!
But the prank called swatting doesn't always end well for the victim. Police body cam footage in 2017 from Wichita, Kansas shows police shooting a man who told 911 he'd just shot his father. Investigators later discovered it was actually this man hundreds of miles away who made the call, and it was all a prank.
I think it's unfortunate that some people take advantage of that.
Monisha's relieved last night's call turned out to be a hoax, but the questions remain, who was the caller and why did he target the man living at this home?
It's a very safe neighborhood around here, and I haven't heard of a serious incident that requires 20 cop cars coming in my whole time being here.
And the victim did not want to go on camera, but a Facebook spokesperson released a statement thanking Palo Alto police for their swift response and saying they are glad their colleague and his family are safe. On the Night Beat, I'm Maria Medina.